We have with us the man who started Dixon Technologies, a consumer electronics and home appliances company in 1993 with only one customer and five members. And today, Mr. Sunil Vachani, the executive chairman, sir, the company is listed. And we also have with us Mr. Atul Lall, the man who's anchored the ship so far, the managing director of the company. Sir, so the business is across five segments. Which of them is the most profitable and what are your plans going forward for that particular segment?
Well, you know, you're asking a question that which of my children is the best. So I love all my children equally and we feel that there's tremendous potential across all the verticals. All of them are going to have profitable growth. We are very confident about all our verticals.
I think what I would like to say, if you also look at each of our segments, the penetration levels are so low in the country. We've talked about this before. If you look at washing machines, the home appliances segment, barely 5% or 6% of the people own a washing machine in the country. In LED TV, barely around 15% people own an LED television. You talked about mobile phones. There are studies which say that India is the fastest growing market for smartphones. So I think all these things point out towards huge consumption uptake in these items. And we feel that more and more of these products are going to be made in India rather than imported from outside, which was the case maybe 5 or 10 years back.
Mr. Lall, so mobile phones contributed nearly 800 crores to your revenue this year. And considering what the capacity utilization of this segment is, it is still very low. So how do you plan to go forward with the mobile segment? And also, as I read the financials, the EBITDA margin for mobile phones is also 0.6% only. So how do you plan to kind of grow that?
You see, we have our anchor customers and we feel the brands that with whom we are associated are going to have a significant growth. So one growth is going to come from there. Second, there is a constant effort being made on new customer acquisition. So the growth is going to come from there. And please appreciate the story of mobile phones has just begun. The ecosystem is just evolving. It's being put in place. And there would be a significant increase in the depth of manufacturing and we're going to be part of that. So you'll see an expansion of margin coming through that.
How soon can we see the mobile motherboard assembling and manufacturing happening, sir?
Well, as you know, the government of India has come out of the phased manufacturing program. And under the first phase, there were duties imposed on certain items like batteries, adapters, headphones. We think that I think in the second or the next phase, there would be duties imposed even on the popular PCB. So we would be moving along with the phased manufacturing program of the government and we'd be creating capacities accordingly. And we would like to make sure that, you know, we are creating capacities which are global in nature and we can compete with the best in the world.
Mr. Vachani, also original design manufacturing and original equipment manufacturing, these are the two businesses that the company is involved in. So which of them is more profitable and where do you plan to increase the focus of the company going forward?
So see, as far as you rightly said, there are two models and there is one the OEM model and second is the ODM model. The OEM model is where we work on the prescriptive mode on the customer's design and ODM as model is the one where we work on our own design. The ODM definitely is more profitable, but OEM also has its own advantages where we work on hardly any working capital. So the ROC there is much, much more than the ODM. So I think each of the business verticals has its own advantages, so to say.
Mr. Lall, although Mr. Vachani does say that the focus will be on ODM, the share of business from ODM kind of fell by nearly 27% from FY16. So what were the reasons for that and how going forward will you kind of cope with that?
No, if you look at the absolute numbers, and there is a large growth in the ODM itself. You see, please appreciate the revenue mix in the company changed. We had a new vertical in mobiles, which contributed more than 800 crores to the revenue. And all of that belongs to the prescriptive OEM model. So I humbly request that please don't look at the percentage numbers, look at the absolute numbers. So there is a large growth in the ODM itself, and that's going to be also the way forward. Also, I would say that, as Mr. Vachani just explained, that both the business models that we have are going to be pursued very aggressively.
So, Mr. Vachani, consumer electronics and mobile phones, will that be mostly under the OEM model or do you plan to shift?
No, even in consumer electronics, we are already manufacturing on an ODM mode, and then we'll see more and more ODM coming in future also. So I think across our segments, maybe mobile is a segment which is still going to work on EMS mode for some time, but the other segments, we will be working more and more on the ODM design.
Mr. Lall, the reverse logistics business, you've spoken about it, and that is a business that has high margins. And currently, as I understand, there are about 18 service centers. Do you plan to grow this business going forward? Are there any plans of opening up new service centers?
You see, we are in three product verticals in reverse logistics. One is set-top boxes. Second is the repair of display, and third is mobile reverse logistics. So we are deepening and we are opening certain state-of-art centers. So we will be continuously expanding a capacity in all these three verticals. We are extremely bullish on this business.
Also, when we look at the company's growth rate, it has maintained a CAGR of 34%. Do you plan to kind of keep it that way going forward?
Yeah. Well, I cannot talk about the numbers on the forward basis, but I think if you see, you rightly mentioned, in revenue terms, we've grown at 33% CAGR. EBITDA terms, almost 44% CAGR, and profit almost 70% CAGR. So these are strong numbers. And as I mentioned, that we would be, investors have given us an overwhelming mandate. And we and our team would, we would work to our best of our ability to ensure that we exceed their expectations on, corporate governance, on transparency and numbers, most importantly.
Mr. Lall, there are some concentrated but marquee clientele that your company has, say Panasonic, Geony, but there are also risks that come from concentrated clientele. So do you kind of plan to diversify that going forward?
You see, as you very correctly mentioned, our anchor relationships are with very leading brands. Philips and lighting, all of us know the kind of market share it has. Panasonic, iconic Japanese brand. So we value those relationships and keep on growing those relationships. However, at the same time, we are on a new customer acquisition spree across all the verticals. So it's going to be both ways.
Mr. Vachani, one last question. So Reliance Retail is also one of your partners. Has Reliance approached you with the Reliance Jio phone, considering you are one of the biggest manufacturers?
Well, we have a very old relationship with Reliance Retail. We've been manufacturing their various products in the last few years, and the relationship has grown from strength to strength. At this moment of time, I won't be able to comment specifically on the the Jio phone order, but I can just say that we have a great relationship, and we hope that this relationship continues to grow across product verticals in times to come.
Thank you, Mr. Vachani. Thank you, Mr. Lall, for speaking to Bloomberg Quint.
Thank you.